Good day, students. Welcome to MathGotServed.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to find limits involving infinity. Feel free to visit our website at MathGotServed.com for access to a wide variety of tutorials ranging from algebra to calculus. Let's take a look at question number one. We are to find the limit as x approaches infinity of the quantity x squared minus 4. This can simply be computed using our substitution. Okay, so let's go ahead and substitute infinity into this quantity right here. This becomes infinity squared minus 4. Okay, now we're just going to carry out some computations involving the arithmetic of infinity to evaluate this expression. If you need more explanation as to how to carry out arithmetic of infinity, visit our YouTube page and search for arithmetic of infinity, or just click on the link below to gain access to those tutorials. Let's go ahead and evaluate this. Infinity squared is simply going to be infinity minus 4. Infinity is so large that when you subtract 4 from it, it has no impact whatsoever. So our answer is infinity. All right, let's take a look at question number two. So we have the square root of a polynomial function divided by another polynomial function. And we're looking for the limit as x approaches negative infinity. So anytime you're dealing with the quotient of two polynomials, it's beneficial to consider growth rates at infinity, okay? So in the numerator, at infinity, the fastest growing term is 2x squared. So we're going to consider the square root of 2x squared. And in the denominator, the fastest growing term is 4x. So this limit can be reduced to the limit as x approaches negative infinity of the square root of 2x squared divided by 4x, okay? Now what we'll do is simplify this resulting limit. So this is going to become the limit as x approaches negative infinity of the square root of 2. If you root x squared, you just have x, divided by 4x, okay? Now we can go ahead and divide. So we'll divide one thing we also have to note is if we take the square root of a square, we're going to have an absolute value quantity here. All right, so now since we're approaching from the left, this absolute value can take on two signs. It could either be positive or negative. So let's go ahead and write this down. So this becomes the limit as x approaches negative infinity of plus or minus x root 2 divided by x, 4x, sorry. All right, since we're going to the left direction, we're going to take the negative sign. If we're going to the positive direction, we'd have taken the positive. So since we're going to negative infinity, we're going to have the limit. This becomes the limit as x approaches negative infinity of, and then you divide, you take the negative x over 4x root 2. Okay, now we can go ahead and divide the x's. X goes here 1, x goes here 1. And we're left with the limit as x approaches negative infinity of negative root 2 over 4. Since this is a constant independent of the direction of x, our final answer will be negative root 2 divided by 4. All right, so that's that. All right, let's take a look at question number 3. We want to find the limit as x approaches infinity of negative natural logarithm of x divided by x to the fourth minus 1. Now we have the quotient of two functions, a polynomial function and a logarithmic function. So we have to consider the growth rates. All right, the natural logarithmic function is the slowest growing function compared to other functions. So let's just keep this fact in mind. If you want to compare most of the functions we deal with, natural logarithmic function is slower than the polynomial function, and the polynomial function is slower than the exponential function, okay? So let's keep that in mind. So what does this mean? This means that at infinity, this behaves like a constant. It's so slow that it behaves like a constant. So we can write this as a limit as x approaches infinity. Let's just set this to, let's call it 1, okay, over x to the fourth minus 1, okay? Because at infinity, comparatively speaking, this behaves just like a constant value. Okay, now let's go ahead and evaluate this limit. We are going to do this by direct substitution, okay? So we have negative 1 over infinity to the fourth minus 1. So this becomes negative 1 over infinity minus 1. Negative 1 over infinity is just 0 minus 1. And your final answer is negative 1. Okay, let's take a look at question number 4. We define the limit as x approaches infinity of cosine x over x plus 4. We can evaluate this by direct substitution. So we have cosine infinity over infinity plus 4. So what is cosine infinity? Well, cosine infinity fluctuates between negative 1 and 1. For the cosine function, divide that by infinity plus 4. Okay? Now what happens when we divide these extreme values by infinity? Any number between negative 1 and 1, including 1 and negative 1 divided by infinity, since this is a finite interval, if you divide it by infinity, you end up with 0. It's as though you were dividing a constant by infinity. Okay? So if you divide a constant by infinity, you have 0 plus 4. Your final answer is 4. All right, let's take a look at question number 5. We're to find the limit as x approaches negative infinity of the third root of 3x squared plus 1 over 4x squared plus 2. All right, let's take a look at question number 5. We're to find the limit as x approaches negative infinity of the third root of 3x squared plus 1 divided by 4x squared plus 2. So since we're taking a look at the limit as x approaches infinity, we can take a look at the growth rate of the numerator and the denominator and extract the fastest growing terms, okay? In the numerator, the fastest growing term is 3x squared. And in the denominator, the fastest growing term is 4x squared. So this limit is the same thing as the limit as x approaches negative infinity of the third root of 3x squared over 4x squared, okay? Let's go ahead and simplify that. This becomes the limit as x approaches negative infinity of the third root of the x squared divide out 3 over 4. We do not need to consider the absolute value situation here since we're taking the third root. Okay? Now, let's go ahead and take the limit. If you take the limit here, this becomes the third root of 3 over 4. All right? This constant is independent of the direction of x. Now let's simplify this. This becomes the third root of 3 divided by the third root of 4. Okay? So to go ahead and simplify this, what we're going to do is express both of them as fractional exponents and then simplify. The denominator may not have a fractional exponent, okay? So that's the goal here. This can be expressed as 3 to the 1/3 divided by 4 to the 1/3. Okay? I can also simplify this further. Write it as 3 to the 1/3 divided by 2 squared to the 1/3. Okay? And then we'll have 3 to the 1/3 divided by 2 to the 2/3. Now I want this exponent, the power of the denominator to be an integer. So I need to make the numerator and the denominator identical. Okay? So how do I make this into a whole number, so to speak? If I multiply the numerator and the denominator by the 2 raised to a fraction that when added to 2/3 gives you a whole number. Okay? So what do I add to 2/3 to get a whole number? I have to add 1/3. Okay, so multiply the numerator and the denominator by 2 to the 1/3. The goal again is you want to eliminate the fractional exponent in the denominator. All right, so we're going to have 3 to the 1/3 times 2 to the 1/3 divided by 2 to the 3/3. All right, so in the numerator, we can just factor out the 1/3 and the 1/3 and write the numerator as the third root of 3 times 2, which is 6, divided by 2 to the 3/3 is just 2. Okay, so there goes your limit. All right, let's take a look at question number 6. We're to find the limit as x approaches infinity of negative e to the negative 4x plus 3. Okay, so we can evaluate this by direct substitution. So we have negative e to the negative 4 times infinity plus 3. Let's simplify further. We're going to have negative e to the negative infinity plus 3. Okay, now this exponent is negative, so we have to reciprocate this term to compensate for the negativity. So we have negative 1 over e to the infinity plus 3. All right, and then this now becomes negative 1 e to the infinity is an infinitely large number plus 3. And then negative 1 over infinity is 0 plus 3. And your final answer is 3. All right. Now let's take a look at the next number. Let's take a look at question number 7. We're to find the limit as x approaches negative infinity of x divided by cosine negative 3x. All right, so this can be computed by direct substitution. So let's substitute infinity into our rational expression here. So we're going to have infinity divided by cosine negative 3 times infinity. Okay, so this becomes infinity divided by cosine negative infinity. So what happens when cosine approaches negative infinity? It oscillates. It oscillates between 1 and negative 1. So we are going to have infinity divided by negative 1, the interval between negative 1 and 1. So it doesn't really approach a specific number. So when you divide infinity between negative 1 and 1 and everything in between, it doesn't really approach a specific number. Okay, so what's going to happen is that you're going to simply be oscillating between negative infinity and infinity. All right? Negative infinity and infinity. Well, technically, we cannot include those two values because infinity and negative infinity are not finite numbers, so this is going to go from negative infinity to infinity. So since you're oscillating wildly between negative infinity and infinity, as x tends towards negative infinity, what's your answer going to be? The limit does not exist. Okay, it doesn't approach a specific y value, hence the limit is non-existent. All right, now you can go ahead and try out the practice problems to make sure that you really master this concept. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other full tutorials such as this. And do post a comment in the comment section to let us know what you think about this tutorial and make requests for other tutorials to aid you in mastering calculus. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.